Have your seats. I would like to ask everybody to silence your phone if possible. Thank you. Dear friends and family, we are here assembled in the presence of God to unite Roberto Delgado and Christian Robinson in marriage. The Bible teaches that marriage is to be a permanent relationship of one man and one woman, freely and totally committed to each other as companions for life. Our Lord declared that man shall leave his father and mother and unite with his wife in the building of a home, and the two shall become one flesh. Who gives this bride to be married?
I do.
Here. Thank you. The home is built upon love, which virtue is best portrayed in the 13th chapter of Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. Love is patient, It's kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things. It believes all things, hopes all things. It also endures all things. Love never ends. So faith, hope, love abide in these three, but the greatest of all of those is love. Marriage is a companionship which involves mutual commitment and responsibility. You will share alike in the responsibility and the joys of life. When companions share a sorrow, the sorrow is split in half. And when they share in joy, your joy shall be doubled. You are exhorted to dedicate your home to your Creator, the Almighty God. Take His word, the Bible, for your guide. Give loyal devotion to His church, thus uniting the mutual strength of these two most important institutions, living your lives as His willing servants, and true happiness will be your temporal and eternal reward. We're going to now hear the Lord's Prayer by Sister Sarai James, my other daughter. Roberto? Will you take Christian to be your wife? Will you commit yourself to her happiness and her self-fulfillment as a person and to her usefulness in God's kingdom? And will you promise to love, honor, trust, and serve her in sickness and in health, and adversity and prosperity, and to be true and loyal to her so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Christian, will you take Roberto to be your husband? Will you commit yourself to his happiness and his fulfillment as a person and to his usefulness in God's kingdom? And do you promise to love, honor, trust, and serve him in sickness and health and adversity and prosperity, and to be true and loyal to him so long as you both shall live?
I do.
All right, we just witnessed them. Both of them are getting ready to serve life sentences. I believe they wanted to exchange some personal vows themselves. No, not the ring.
No.
Oh, okay.
Dang.
All right, we are here.
Christian, I'll never forget the first day I saw you at FedEx. It was my first day. All I heard was some loud laugh, and I look over and I just saw the biggest smile ever, and we locked eyes, and I could not stop staring. I had my mouth wide open, and from that day I just knew I had to have you. My life has been so great ever since you came into it. I felt like God sent me an angel. You're so good for me. You keep me in line and in direction. And for that, I love you. We're so much alike, but so different at the same time. Not only are you my wife, but you are my best friend as well. I wouldn't be anything without you. You're the missing piece to my puzzle, and you're somebody I've been looking for all my life. I hope we grow old together, and I can't wait to see what the future has for us. But I know I'll succeed in more with my queen, Christian.
Roberto, my love. Roberto. It's so big. And I love you just never seems like this sometimes. You are my rock. You were there for me. Like even when you didn't have to be there. Even when we were just friends. You always seemed like you cared. Never in a million years did I think in 2013 I would be getting married. I remember always telling you I didn't want a boyfriend until I was 25 years old. So persistent. And for that I thank you because you were the best thing that ever happened to me. You are everything I asked God for. Everything specifically. And I love you. Sorry. Thank you. From this day forward, I promise to love you, to learn you, to work with you. It's me and you till the end, okay? Nobody can break that but us. You are a godsend. You my baby, you're my king, and I love you.
The wedding ring is a symbol of marriage in at least two ways. The purity of gold symbolizes the purity of your love for each other, and the unending circle symbolizes the unending vows which you are taking, which may be broken honorably in the sight of God only by death. As a token of your vows, you will give and receive rings. Roberto. My son. You're going to give Christian this ring and repeat after me. Christian.
Christian.
With this ring, I pledge my life and love to you.
This ring, I pledge my life and love to you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
The Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
You may put the ring on. Christian. Repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I pledge my love and life to you.
I pledge my love and life to you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
The Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
You may place the ring. Okay, I need both of you guys to face me and repeat after me. Entreat me not to leave you.
Entreat me not to leave you.
Or to return from following you.
Or to return from following you.
For where you go,
for where you go,
I will go.
I will go.
And where you lodge,
where you lodge,
I will lodge.
I will lodge.
Your people shall be my people.
Shall be my people.
And
your God
shall be my God.
Shall be my God.
Amen. All right, we're gonna prepare for the sand ceremony. Amen. Thank you.
All right. This sand that's already placed in the vial represents your faith in God, which is your foundation. Amen. Now, Roberto, pour your sand into the vial. Now, Christian, pour your sand into the vial. This represents both of your families coming together, and they're sitting on your foundation of faith in God. Now, Roberto, pour your sand in the vial, which represents your individualism. Now, Christian, pour your sand in the vial, which represents your individualism. Now they're in the vial together. You guys are no longer two. You are one. And I'm placing on top this sand, which represents your faith in God. This is Christian's family and her and Roberto's relationship. It cannot be broken, just as these sands cannot be separated. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
I'm going to ask Elder Delgado to bless them in prayer over their lives. This is Roberto's father. Give him a hand, praise.
Father, thank you so much for showing up today at 6 p.m. on a Friday, the 26th of July. It's not an accident that Christian and Roberto met. It was your will. You are in the miracle business. You performed the miracle the day they met, and today, you supersize that miracle by bringing two into one. Father, in the years to come, protect them. You're a super spectacular God. We're not looking for just an okay marriage here. We're not looking for maybe a B minus or an A minus. You give them a triple A plus marriage forever and ever, Father. May they always be there for each other through thick and thin. And when they have low moments, they don't need to talk to the mailman or their best friend. Their best friend is Jesus Christ. Let them go to them first, their parents second, and anybody else has been married 9,000 years like their parents. So Father, please look out for them all the time. May they always communicate with each other. May they never go to bed upset at each other. May they never go to that J-O-B that they go to after they turn off their alarm clock mad at each other. May nothing, especially the enemy, come into them, because we know the enemy is here for one reason, to break up the family. But today, that family was brought together, and please look out for them the rest of their life, Father. May they be blessed, if it's your will, with Roberto Jr. if they want. Another Christian. Whatever they want, Father, but you are in the miracle business. You're the one that brought everybody here on 80 in this traffic, little breezy in the chairs, listening to my long-winded speech. Yes. This is my baby boy, my youngest son getting married. He means everything in the world to me, just like the rest of my boys and my daughter and my family and everybody sitting in this chair. They mean everything to the Delgado family and the Robinson family. You know that. People standing in the back, they mean everything in the world to me, Father, so please protect them likewise. And in closing, Father, because you are a father that's here, he's back here, he's everywhere. May you always, always keep them in the right path. Make godly decisions. Walk with you, Father. On Sundays, they sit next to each other in church with their Bible right there as they pray, as they do every Sunday. Keep them with you, Father. And if they walk with you, it's guaranteed the next time they're walking on a different path, because it's right there on Judgment Day, the day they walk with you to paradise. Look out for them, Father. We love you with all our heart. Amen.
Amen.
Friends and family, since they have made these commitments before God in this assembly, or all of these witnesses, by the authority of God and the laws of this state, I declare that Roberto Duran Delgado and Christian Bayon Robinson Delgado are husband and wife. All right, be careful. I present to you today, as husband and wife, Roberto and Christian Delgado. Hey!
Thank you.
26, 2013, mark that, you feel me? Today is the day, you know what I'm saying?
Right now, but he is. I'm proud of him for growing up and And congratulations to Amy Christian, from new sister, second sister.
Fred and Christian. Okay. So I'm very proud of you guys for growing up. I'm very proud of you, sister, for becoming a beautiful woman and taking the steps that in your life. Brandon, if you need me and Aaron, we got a headlock. I don't know if you're crazy. but we love you guys, and we're always here for you.
Joe, I want to say something.
Come on, somebody. You can tell he ain't never.
Only night he was a gangster.
Yeah,
gangster Mike.
Christian, hey, Ren, I just want to wish you guys the best of luck. Red, the best of luck. Whatever she say, Red, do it. Because I'm still growing hair from when she pulled mine out. Yeah, I'm done. Okay. I love you guys.
I have to get out of here. My back hurts.
I wish you guys the best. And I love you, Red, just as much as I love Christian. I'm glad I have a new cousin to bother. And I wish you guys the best. And I want a little cousin.
Basically, I'll let you guys vote for me, Christian, and Red. All right, well, Christian and Red, you was pretty cool. I like your vibe automatically. And Christian, you already know what it is, so yeah.
She told me about you already knew, like, you was already good vibes, everything was going to be smooth, even though I didn't know your first name for like a good year, I ain't gonna lie. She told everybody his name was Red, I kid you not. Never Roberto, never Robert, Red. I wish y'all the best of luck. I'm here for y'all no matter what, me and Leah, you know, family. I'll be here for you.
I care about her.
I love you guys.
Oh, I got it. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Christian and Roberto. Let me get Christian. You got to talk to him.
Congratulations. Even though we just started liking each other maybe a week ago, congratulations to Christian. I love you like a sister. I'm here for you whenever you need me. I'm going to make it. I got you. Congratulations. Don't hurt it. Don't come at me if you do.
Thank you.
Flip up, bro. Oh!
Oh! Christian and Roberto, congratulations. I'm proud of you both. May you guys be blessed with an incredible marriage, always. The party is, this is the party of parties. Enjoy it. We're having a great time. Enjoy yourself the rest of your life. May the rest of your life be just like this party. God bless you guys.
Blurred lines.
Trying to domesticate
you.
Children animals.
Like, what's y'all doing?
He getting that right there.
I got something for you. Hold on, wait a minute.
Come on, Steve. Come on, Steve.
I know what we're doing. I know what we're doing.
Steve.
I'm talking about him.
Oh, hello? I'm getting a call from reality.
Happy, I'm working. Oh, I'm doing my dirt now. Think about you get hurt. I'm really singing like that. And I can't really who sees me. So long, so long. Thinking about me being a better girl that you are.
Hold on, hold on.
He got like move.
You did kind of move a little bit there. Good job.
It's the floor, isn't it?
But if you hurt, you hurt.
I can't even do it.
You did kind of hit that.